I will keep this very brief. My time is low. I do want to share a few things that I believe will speak loudly to this church. And first, I'd like to talk about Pastor Drew. I just have a few things I'd like to share with the congregation, and I think if you take these and you live them out for the next few months especially, it will make his transition here and his family's experience here a great one. I really would ask if you would be kind enough, starting next week, when he's here and his wife's here, would you find somehow to wear a name tag? Would you do that next week? Would you do that for July? Would you do that for August? And would you do that for September? It might get old wearing name tags for 3 months, but I found something really exciting about this church. We have new people every week. I think it's going to work well. And there's no way Pastor Drew's going to remember all your names in 1 week. That's impossible. You might get his name down really fast, but do that for the first 2 or 3 months. Those "Hello, my name is" stickers, it'll go a long way. I think he'll feel welcomed into this church if he sees the ability to call you by name. That'll mean a lot to him and his family. I also want to ask if you would give Pastor Drew permission to change things. I believe change can be exciting. I believe when you see change, that can be sometimes where the Spirit moves the most. And while it could be really tempting to say, things are going in a nice direction right now, just sail the boat, Drew. Don't steer course left or right. Just sail. And I want you to give him permission to steer that boat left or right. And I want you to stand next to him when there's a mistake, and I want you to allow him a chance or two to have a failure. That's fine. We all do. I could stand up here and tell you my worst moments, but that wouldn't be a very good way to leave on, so we're not going to do that. But also do this. When you see Pastor Drew succeed in something, and when you see the Spirit really work strong, I want you to pull him aside. And I want you to tirelessly tell him how proud you are, how excited you are, and how much you can't wait to see what continues to happen with his ministry in this church. I think if you take those things to heart, he will absolutely feel at home in this church week one, and he will want to stay here as long as you let him and as long as God keeps him in this building. Sound good? Give me an amen.
Amen.
I appreciate that. Seven of you were like, does that mean applaud, or what do I do? Second thing I want to share with you, and I will keep this incredibly brief, I'm excited for this church as they stand on the edge of an upcoming building program sometime this year or next year, sometime in the near future. I am tremendously excited for the direction of this church. I will look back on this church and see it continue to grow and to blossom physically and spiritually, and that's exciting. That's exactly what I want to see in every church I have my fingerprints on. But I just want to give you one sentence to consider over the next year or two as you start walking towards this great adventure, and it really is. There's a mentality that's really popular when it comes to building programs, but it's a real dangerous one. And that mentality is, build it and they will come. It's a really nice saying, but it doesn't work with church growth. It doesn't work with new buildings being added on to an existing church. The idea that if you build it and then you can just sit back and watch the people come in and ministry will happen, that doesn't happen. The reality is, when you step forward as a church and you do something great like build a new something or add on to something or renovate something, all that means is it's time to roll up your sleeves. Because every square foot that you add on to this church means there's got to be more people serving and more people active and more people contributing. The larger this campus, the more potential this campus has at reaching the community, but the more we need our church to step forward and be a part of that process. If you ever hear the phrase, build it and they will come over the next 2 years, say, we don't live by that phrase. We're going to live by the phrase, build it and bring it. Because if this church really wants to see the kingdom blossom over the next 2 years with something that's added on or renovated, I ask that instead of you saying build it and they will come, say build it and bring it. Because this church is going to bring it. They're going to bring it spiritually. They're going to step forward. Maybe some of the people that don't regularly serve, they're going to say, you know what, now it's time for me to regularly serve. Maybe some of the people who have been considering, should I be a leader, maybe it's time for them to talk to the pastor or some lay leadership and say, what can I do to take a step forward? I really pray as this building physically grows, the kingdom spiritually grows, and each and every one of you find the challenge inside of you to say, yes, it's time for me to step forward. I want to live for Christ because this church is choosing to grow for Christ. Does that sound good? Amen. Amen. Thanks. I have 1 minute left, and in that minute I want to tell you, it has been a profound honor to serve this church. I've loved every day. These 3 years have been great. I have rediscovered how ministry should be ran and operated in these 3 years. When I walked through these doors, I didn't walk through these doors planning on empowerment to be a strategy, planning on leadership development to be a strategy, planning on small group cultivation to be a strategy, planning on Bible study explosion to be a strategy. These weren't things I walked into this church with. When I walked into this church, all I could think of was one thing. Boy, Pastor Alex was good. I hope I just don't screw it all up. So when I came into this church, the first year God really spoke to me and gave me some powerful ideas, and then I had the joy of running with them on years 2 and 3. And this church, I pray this church has seen great things in its young adult life, in its youth life. Those are things that will continue to happen in those programs with Pastor Drew, and those are things that will continue to contagiously affect this church day after day after day. It has been a profound pleasure. It has been an honor of mine to serve as your pastor. This will be a chapter in my life that will not be forgotten. And if my memories start losing as I get older, as sometimes they do with older people, I hope my memories in this church are the last ones that are taken. Thank you so much for letting me be your pastor.